was a large turnout today of couriers from the app-based delivery service Foodora, who gathered here at the Ontario Labour Relations Board with representatives from their company. The workers are pushing to form a union, claiming poor treatment and wages. Foodora, not surprisingly, is fighting against it, saying the workers don't have the right. Well, now it will be up to a Labour Board arbitrator to decide.
It's just gotten worse and worse and worse, and we've gotten to the point where, like, we need to fight for our own rights.
38-year-old Alex Court has worked for Foodora for more than 3 years. It's one of five jobs he juggles. The majority are in the so-called gig economy. In other words, more temporary or short-term engagements. With Foodora, he used to feel like he was part of a team. Not anymore.
Over the years, that relationship has really started to deteriorate, and it's become much more of a exploitative and cold and inhumane kind of feeling in that day-to-day parts of the job.
To illustrate this, one worker shared with me a text that he says is a typical response from the company to injury. In this case, he says a courier fell and broke her arm during a delivery. The dispatcher allegedly said, "We will need you to complete the order that you have accepted. Do you want me to take a picture right now? No, we need you to complete the order." Foodora reps refused to comment on active legal proceedings, but one of their main arguments against the workers is that they claim their couriers are independent contractors, not employees, and therefore don't have the right to unionize. The lawyer for CUPW says this is just not true. He says Foodora controls every aspect of the job, and it's exactly the same relationship as employer to employee.
We think the issue is very simple. We think these are people who are laboring under terms and conditions of employment that Foodora sets. They are clearly dependent upon the company, and we think that they need to go to the bargaining table with their employees.
Organizing would likely mean higher wages, at least minimum wage, which workers say they often don't make now, a more fair allocation of shifts, closer attention paid to health and safety issues, vacation pay and other benefits. And CUPW is confident they will succeed.
It comes down to the preponderance of evidence. Does it look like a duck or does it not look like a duck?
And it looks like a duck. Meyer Simiatiki agrees. He's a professor specializing in labor policy. He believes Foodora couriers are employees and says all eyes in Canada will be watching this case. If the workers are successful in winning the right to unionize, it'll set a precedent and may open the floodgates.
This is a historic case. We have a whole cohort of workers who are part of this booming app economy, gig economy, who are, for the first time in the Canadian context, seeking unionization. So this is a really important litmus test for the entire sector.
Now, couriers in Toronto attempted to unionize about 10 years ago, long before there was such a thing as Foodora or other app-based services, and they were successful. But the company pushed back so hard against the workers that they gave up and the union was dissolved, something that these workers could face in the future. It'll likely be a few months before a decision is made. Hearings are scheduled, at least five of them, through till the end of January.